Not long ago, I saw a photo of a fire whirl, which was a spawn of a fiery element. Just imagine a huge column of fire that moves, sweeping and igniting everything in its path. I was wondering, is this real? It turns out that yes. A fire whirl or fire tornado exists, although it is a very rare natural phenomenon. Why? It's quite simple. To form such a whirl, you need several strong fire sources close to each other, as well as a very strong headwind. The air above the fire sources heats up, becomes lighter, and rises up accordingly. Cold air masses enriched with oxygen come to the place of the heated air from below. The incoming air also heats up, and thus the air flows begin to twist. These very flows, rotating counterclockwise, form the very fire whirls. Why counterclockwise? Well, it's all about the hemisphere. Interestingly, the height of such columns can reach up to 5 kilometers. As in ordinary tornadoes, in fire whirls the speed of the hot air flows reaches hurricane speeds above 400 kilometers per hour, and the temperature reaches up to 1000 degrees Celsius. Naturally, everything burns and melts at such temperatures. The whirlwind sucks in everything that is in close proximity, and so until it destroys everything. Horrifying, isn't it? One of the fundamental features of this type of whirlwind is that it can be caused by human factors. For example, a whirlwind can occur as a result of large fires. But for this, a rare combination of several factors is necessary: high atmospheric pressure, hot weather, and very low humidity. It is precisely for this reason that such factors are rarely encountered together. Fire whirls are quite rare phenomena for us. And this cannot but rejoice, because hardly anything or anyone can resist the raging element. One such example is the fire whirl that occurred as a result of the British Air Force raid on Hamburg in July 1943. As a result, the element burned almost everything and everyone that came across its path. By the way, Hamburg suffered from the whirlwind twice. The first time it was in 1942, and the cause of the whirlwind was a fire, not a bombing, as in 43. It should be noted that Hamburg is not the only city that suffered from the fire element. At different times, such cities as London, Chicago, Stalingrad, Hiroshima, and many others suffered from whirlwinds. The cause of the whirlwind was either trivial fires or bombings. But whirlwinds occurred and occur not only in large cities. Sometimes they are the offspring of forest fires. For example, a resident of Santa Barbara, California, managed to capture a fire whirl that hit his city. The tornado arose against the background of forest fires that raged in California since May. The area of the fire then exceeded 1,500 hectares. The spread of fire was provoked by unprecedented heat on the west coast of the United States. There the thermometers rose to the 40-degree mark. Australian Chris Tangey also managed to capture a rare natural phenomenon: a fire whirl about 30 meters high. The burning column appeared near the city of Alice Springs, Australia. Amazed, Tangey watched the burning tornado for about 40 minutes. Another case occurred in the US state of Kentucky, where a hurricane destroyed a warehouse of alcoholic products of the Jim Beam Company as a result of the impact of the elements. More than 3 million liters of bourbon spilled into the nearest river. It caught fire from a lightning strike. And then the tornado lifted the burning liquid tens of meters above the surface of the earth and water. Thus, a tornado born of fire is a beautiful and terrible phenomenon that turns everything to ashes.